last 2 days have seen the visits of BJP National General Secretary Organization, Mr. B.L. Santosh, as well as the in charge of Uttar Pradesh for BJP, Mr. Radha Mohan Singh, visit Lucknow and have one-to-one meetings with a series of BJP leaders, ministers in UP, asking them about the organization, about the working of the government, about how the party and the government are preparing for the elections in Uttar Pradesh, which are supposed to happen in February, March next year. Now, this visit has led to a lot of rumors, political talk along the grapevine that what is the idea behind this. I think one thing which has been conclusively established from these meetings is that Yogi Adityanath, Chief Minister, will continue to be the leader of the party as the party goes into the elections next year. He will lead the party into the elections. There is no challenge to him. In fact, Yogi Adityanath, I think, has emerged as an undisputed and unchallenged leader of the BJP in UP right now. The center is completely backing him. That includes the Prime Minister and the Home Minister. Basically, many things have been there which have gone for the CM in the past few years. One obviously has been his clean image. The center has also been very impressed with Yogi Adityanath's governance model in UP, as well as the sheer hard work on the ground, which involves, you know, going for reviews across the state, visiting the state, ground visits. Even after in this present COVID crisis, we have seen him tour almost the entire state in a matter of 25 to 26 days as soon as he recovered from COVID. But from where does this grapevine come from? Now, UP underwent panchayat polls recently where the BJP did not do that well. After that, the COVID pandemic hit the second wave, in which UP saw a real number of high numbers going up to 38,000, 39,000 cases per day. And the estimates in the center was that the things could go really bad. And in fact, Mr. VK Paul, in a presentation at the PM-CM's meeting on April 23rd, warned that daily cases in UP could hit even over 1 lakh in May. This is when the Chief Minister seems to have stepped into the situation and given clear instruction that this cannot be allowed to happen. Through his ground visits, through his instructions on how the government geared up its machinery, the cases are now at a record low after a month, and the recovery rate is very high. Surprisingly, in UP, the testing is also very high. So it is not a case where, you know, testing has been reduced to show a lower number of cases. So UP is showing that UP has claimed that it has controlled corona to a large extent. And that is also a factor which, interestingly, in a tweet last night, Mr. B.L. Santosh, who headed these one-to-one meetings with various leaders in UP, specified that Yogi Adityanath has done an exemplary job in controlling COVID, and the record number of drop in the cases which has come, the party is happy with that. So that is quite a conclusive tweet to say that there is no change of guard being expected in UP at the top level. But yes, changes at the organizational level, changes in the cabinet of the UP government are expected. There are a couple of reasons for that. One, that there are spots, vacant spots in the cabinet. Some few ministers have passed away tragically due to COVID, and there were vacant spots in the cabinet which need to be filled up. So the caste combinations need to be taken care of before the elections. We could see a cabinet reshuffle where some people are inducted into the cabinet and some ministers from the cabinet are maybe inducted into organizational work in the BJP ahead of the elections, because BJP is also planning to shore up its organizational strength in the state to take on the Samajwadi Party, the Bahujan Samaj Party and the Congress. So both organizational and cabinet changes are expected at some level, and B.L. Santosh and Radha Mohan Singh are expected to brief the senior leadership in Delhi about their feedback, speaking to various leaders in Lucknow. Also, a key factor in why, you know, these rumor mills start that there can be a change at the top level in UP, those do not hold much weight, because if you see in the BJP right now, the CM Yogi Adityanath enjoys a very clear and a very unchallenged position. Whoever other senior BJP leaders of the state were, either are out of the state politics or are not in a position to challenge him anymore. In the last election, we saw on the posters also Mr. Rajnath Singh, the then Home Minister and present Defence Minister and the Lucknow MP, his face on the posters, but Mr. Rajnath Singh was never inclined to go back to the state politics as the Chief Minister. We had Mr. Kalraj Mishra, who was sent later to, who was also an MP from Deoria, who was later sent to Rajasthan as the Governor. And Mr. Manoj Sinha, who lost the election from Ghazipur in the last Lok Sabha and was later accommodated as the Lieutenant Governor in Jammu and Kashmir. He is presently the LG in Jammu and Kashmir. So in a way, Mr. Kalraj Mishra, Mr. Rajnath Singh and Manoj Sinha are actively out of state politics and into other roles. The only person who is still in state politics, who was a face in the last election, is Mr. Keshav Prasad Maurya, who is the deputy CM right now. But there is very remote chance that Keshav Prasad Maurya can pose a challenge to the top chair, to Mr. Yogi Adityanath. Whatever we are hearing from the BJP is that Yogi Adityanath will lead the party into the elections next year. In fact, he is seen as the best bet in the elections next year, because if you remember, BJP has never returned to power for a second term immediately in any past election in UP. So this time they're trying to, big victory which came last time with 300 plus seats, BJP is trying to do a repeat of the same, and they see Yogi Adityanath as perhaps the best bet going into these elections.